Welcome to the delightful adventures of Peter Rabbit and Benjamin Bunny by Beatrix Potter. Click on either of the blue arrows until you come to your name. Once you've found your name, click on the sign with the green arrow. If your name isn't here, go to the parent menu, then you can type your name. We're off to the marvelous country world of Peter Rabbit. If you would like to hear about the adventures of Peter Rabbit, click on Peter and you can read his story. If you would like to hear about Peter's cousin, Benjamin Bunny, click on Benjamin and you can read his story.
The Tale of Peter Rabbit. Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits, and their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter.
To go on to the next page, click the sign with the green arrow.
Flopsy, one of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Mopsy, one of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Cottontail, one of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Peter Rabbit, a naughty rabbit who steals Mr. McGregor's vegetables.
Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits, and their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter.
Very well then, we'll read you the story.
They lived with their mother in a sandbank, underneath the root of a very big fir tree.
Mother, a female parent. Sandbank, a bank of sloping sandy earth. Underneath, under or below something else. Root, the part of the plant that grows underground. Fir tree. An evergreen tree with needle-like leaves and cones.
They lived with their mother in a sandbank, underneath the root of a very big fir tree. Now, my dears, said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, you may go into the fields or down the lane. But don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden.
My dears, a term of affection. Mrs. Rabbit, Peter Rabbit's mother, and Benjamin Bunny's aunt. Morning, the first part of the day when you wake up after the night. Field, fenced or walled space used for crops or grazing animals. Lane, a narrow path or road. Often in the country, Mr. McGregor's garden. The garden where Peter Rabbit goes to steal vegetables.
Now, my dears, said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning,
Peter. I like bread and milk and blackberries. So do I.
Apply Dapply, a little brown mouse, goes to the cupboard in somebody's house. In somebody's cupboard there's everything nice. Cake, cheese, jam, biscuits, all charming for mice. Apply Dapply has little sharp eyes, and Apply Dapply is so fond of pies.
My children will be home soon. What shall I prepare for them? Oh, yes. Blackberry milkshakes would be perfect. To make blackberry milkshakes, first I'll need some fresh blackberries. Nice, juicy blackberries. I'll need some sugar. Now, what did I do with the milk? That goes in with the blackberries. Last but not least, the ice cream. Now, where did I put the ice cream? Now to pour it into a very large glass. This is going to be delicious. You can try another recipe by clicking on the cookbook. My children will be home soon. Lemonade is just the thing. You can't make lemonade without lemons. There are my lemons. I'll have to squeeze the lemons well. You can't make lemonade without sugar. I need some sugar. I'll just make the lemon juice a bit sweeter with the sugar. I need hot water to make lemonade. The kettle's boiling. I'll just melt the sugar with the hot water. I'll wait for it to cool and then serve it with ice. That will be refreshing. My children will be home. They so like icing on their cake. I'll need some sugar. I need to sift the sugar into a bowl to get out all the lumps. Now I'll need a lemon. I must squeeze a little lemon juice into the bowl. Now I'll need some cream cheese. Here it is, cream cheese. I'll mix it all until it's smooth and creamy. Now I can ice my cake. My children will be home soon. What shall I put? They love cakes for tea. Let me see now. Little cakes are made with butter. Here's the butter. Then I'll add the sugar. Now I need 2 eggs. I must be careful not to put in any eggshell. Now to measure the flour. I have to add the flour a little at a time. I shall hurry them into the oven so they'll be ready to eat soon. My children will be home soon. What shall I prepare for them?
Now, my dears. Herbs. Basket. You know the old woman who lived in a shoe and had so many children she didn't know what to do? I think if she lived in a little shoe house, that little old woman was surely a mouse. Umbrella. Now who is this knocking at Cottontail's door? Tap, tap it, tap, tap it, she's heard it before. And when she peeps out, there is nobody there, but a present of carrots put down on the stair. Hark, I hear it again. Tap, tap, tap it, tap, tap it. Why, I really believe it's a little black rabbit. There once was an amiable guinea pig who brushed back his hair like a periwig. He wore a sweet tie, as blue as the sky, and his whiskers and buttons were very big. Bedtime. Rabbit hole.
To begin, you must choose the number of nuts you want to play with. Click on a nut pile to make your selection. Try to catch all 20 nuts.
Now, my dears, your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor.
Father, male parent.
Accident, something bad which happens unexpectedly or by chance.
Pie, baked meat or fruit covered by a pastry lid. Mrs. McGregor, Mr. McGregor's wife, who put Peter Rabbit's father in a pie.
Your father had an... Now run along and don't get into mischief. I am going out.
Goodbye, Mother. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I'm going out. Goodbye, Mother.
Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns.
Mrs. Rabbit, Peter Rabbit's mother, and Benjamin Bunny's aunt. Basket. A woven bag or container with a handle used to carry things. Umbrella. A folding device used to keep water from falling on you when it is raining. Wood. An area where a lot of trees and other plants grow together. Baker. Someone who makes bread and cakes for people to buy. Loaf of brown bread. Bread made with brown or wholemeal flour in the shape of the mould it was baked in. Currant buns. Sweet rolls with dried fruit similar to raisins. Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood.
To begin, you must...
Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. Bunnies. Young rabbits. Blackberries. Wild fruits in the same family as raspberries, which grow on very prickly bushes in woods and hedgerows. Lane. A narrow path or road, often in the country. Gather. To pick or collect. Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries.
Where's Peter? The top berries are the best. My paws are all purple.
But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. Naughty. Badly behaved. Mischievous. Straight away. At once. Mr. McGregor's garden. The garden where Peter Rabbit goes to steal vegetables. Squeezed. Pressed himself. Gate. A kind of door in a wall or fence. But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate.
That was easy.
First he ate some lettuces and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes. Lettuces. A leafy plant eaten raw in salads. French beans. A kind of bean of which you may eat the whole pod. Radishes. Small, red vegetables which grow underground and have a crunchy, peppery taste.
Radishes! My favourite!
Radishes. Lettuces.
To begin, you must select the number of cabbages you wish to play with. The fewer cabbages you play with, the easier the game. You've decided to try it with 10. See if you can find 5 pairs. Click another cabbage. Let's click another cabbage, shall we? Have another go. Well, those don't match. Splendid! Those two are the same. Those two are a... Try again! Well done! Well done! You found a match! Well done! You've matched them all!
potatoes, wheelbarrow.
We have a little garden, a garden of our own. And every day we water there the seeds that we have sown. We love our little garden and tend it with such care. You will not find a faded leaf or blighted blossom there.
Tool shed. Flower pot. Lettuces. Ladybird, ladybird, fly away home. Your house is on fire and your children all gone. All except one, and her name is Anne. And she has crept under the pudding pan. And then, feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley. Feeling. Knowing something inside yourself. Sick. Ill or nauseated. Parsley. A garden herb with finely divided leaves used to season or garnish food. And then, feeling rather... Potatoes.
But round the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Round the end, around cucumber frame, a wooden and glass box in which cucumber plants are grown to protect them from the cold and frost. Round the end, around the corner. But round the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Round the end, around the corner. Cucumber frame. A wooden and glass box in which cucumber plants are grown to protect them from the cold and frost. Mr. McGregor. A gardener who does not like rabbits eating his vegetables. But round the end of...
You rascal! You rascal!
Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting out young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake and calling out, "Stop, thief!" Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting out young cabbages. Young cabbages. Cabbage plants which are very small and have just begun to grow. Seedlings. Knees.
The bony part or joint in the middle of your leg where it bends. Planting out. Spacing out young plants which have reached seedling stage. Young cabbages. Cabbage jump. To move up or spring suddenly off the ground. Peter Rabbit. A naughty rabbit who steals Mr. McGregor's vegetables. Waving a rake. To shake an instrument or tool used for gardening. Thief. Someone who takes things which belong to someone else. Mr. McGregor. Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. Dreadfully. Very. Extremely. Frightened. Afraid. Garden. A piece of ground used for growing flowers and vegetables. Gate. A kind of door in a wall or fence. Peter was most dreadfully. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other shoe amongst the potatoes. Lost. Not knowing where you are. Among. In the middle of. Amongst. In the midst of. Potatoes. Large vegetables which grow under the ground. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other shoe amongst the potatoes. After losing them, he ran on four legs and went faster, so that I think he might have got away altogether. If he had not unfortunately run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket, it was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new. Unfortunately. Unluckily. Gooseberry net. A net used to cover gooseberry bushes to keep birds from stealing the fruit. Jacket. A short coat with long sleeves. Jacket. Brass buttons. A round fastener made of metal used to do up clothes. If he had not unfortunately run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket, it was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new.
Oh, help! I'm stuck! Oh, help! I'm stuck!
Peter gave himself up for lost and shed big tears, but his sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows. Up for lost. Given up on something or someone. Shed. To let tears fall in drops or flow. Sobs. Loud cries. Weeping. Overheard. Accidentally listened to someone else's conversation. Sparrows. Small brown perky birds often found in gardens and parks. Peter gave himself up for lost, who flew to him in great excitement and implored him to exert himself.
Don't give up, Peter! Hurry, Peter! Come on, Peter!
Mrs. McGregor will put me in a pie!
Excitement. Feeling thrilled. Full of emotion. Implored. Begged. Pleaded. Exert. Try very hard. Who flew... Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the top of Peter, but Peter wriggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind him. Sieve. A container with holes in it, used to sift stones and sticks from soil. Intended. Meant. Pop upon. To catch something by placing something quickly over it. Wriggled. Twisted and turned like a worm. Just in time. Before it is too late, at the last moment.
Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the...
Ha! I've got you now, you wee pest.
And rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Tool shed. A small building that is used to keep tools in. Jump. To move up or spring suddenly off the ground. Can. A container made of metal for holding liquids. And rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it.
It's full of water!
Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. Underneath. Under or below something else. Flower pot. A clay or terracotta container used to grow flowers in. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each.
I'll find you, you wee rascal!
Carefully, safely, with caution. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each. Presently, Peter sneezed.
Ka-tishu!
Mr. McGregor was after him in no time.
There he is.
Sneezed. A sudden rush of air coming from your nose. Presently. After a while. Ka-tishu! A funny sound made when you sneeze. Mr. McGregor was after him in no time. Presently. And tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting three plants. Upon. On or on top of something. Jump. To move up or spring suddenly off the ground. Upsetting three plants. Knocking over three plants. And tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting three plants.
That was dreadfully close.
The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to his work.
I cannot waste all day chasing rabbits.
Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. Rest. To relax and take a break from doing something. Out of breath. Puffing and panting as if you have just been running. Trembling with fright. Shaking and shivering because you were afraid. Not the least idea. Not knowing. Peter sat down. Also, he was very damp with sitting in that can.
And I'm all wet.
Damp. A little wet. Moist. Also, after a time he began to wander about, going lippity-lippity, not very fast, and looking all round. Wander. To move in no particular direction. Aimlessly. Lippity. A word invented by Beatrix Potter to describe the sound of an animal walking slowly and unevenly. He found a door in a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath.
It's locked.
Locked. Closed with a key. He found a door in a wall. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peas. A very small, round green vegetable, which grows in a pod on a vine-like plant. Beans. Small round vegetables, which grow in a row inside a long pod or case. Bean plants are trained to grow up a frame which supports the heavy pods. Wood. An area where a lot of trees and other plants grow together. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her head at him. Peter began to cry. Gate. A kind of door in a wall or fence. Peas. Shook. Moved from side to side to mean no. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she...
Excuse me, please. Could you direct me to the gate?
Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled. Straight across. Opposite. Puzzled. Confused. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became... Presently he came to a pond, where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. Pond. A pool of water. Water cans. Containers with spouts which are filled with water to water the plants. Presently he came to a pond, where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. Water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still, but now and then the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive. Goldfish. An orange or golden-coloured fish of the carp family, often kept in ponds in gardens. Twitched. Made a quick movement with a part of the body. Rabbits twitch their noses. A white cat. Peter thought it best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. Cousin? You're Benjamin Bunny. Peter Rabbit's cousin. Peter thought it best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin.
Cousin Benjamin says they're dangerous.
He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scritch, scratch, scratch, scritch. Noises. Sounds. Often loud or frightening. Hoe. A garden tool with a long handle and small sharp head used for digging up weeds. Scritch. A word invented by Beatrix Potter to describe the scraping sound made by a hoe being used. Scratch. A scraping sound. He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly...
Rabbits! They've been digging in my garden and stealing my vegetables.
Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon a wheelbarrow and peeped over. Wheelbarrow. A small cart with handles and one wheel in the front which you push. Peeped over. Looked quickly over. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but
Rabbits! They've been digging in my garden and stealing my vegetables.
Potatoes. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Hoe. A garden onions. Round white vegetables with a strong taste and smell which may make tears come to your eyes. The first thing he saw was Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go along a straight walk behind some blackcurrant bushes. Quietly, making very little sound. Along, from one end to the other. Run along, off you go, straight walk, a narrow, straight path, blackcurrant bushes. Low garden plants on which black currants grow. Peter got down very quietly off the
Rabbits! They've been digging in my garden and stealing my vegetables.
I'll have to run.
Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter did not care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden.
Ah-ha! I got you now.
Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and the shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Jacket. A short coat with long sleeves. Scarecrow. A dummy, which looks like a real person, dressed in old clothes and put in a field or vegetable patch to scare birds away. Frighten. To make someone afraid. Blackbirds. European songbirds of the thrush family, often seen in gardens. The male birds are black with a yellow beak. Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and the shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. Mr. McGregor's garden. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. Flopped. Collapsed, fallen down. Rabbit hole. Underground burrow where rabbits live. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes.
Peter's late for supper. What's wrong with Peter? What's wrong with Peter?
His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was the second little jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. Busy. Having many things to do. Wondered. Asked oneself questions. It was the second little jacket and pair of shoes. Lost. Not knowing where you are. Fortnight. 2 weeks. His mother was busy. I am sorry to say that Peter was not very well during the evening.
My tummy aches.
Evening. The end of the day. I am sorry to say that Peter was not very well during the evening.
My tummy aches.
His mother put him to bed and made some chamomile tea, and she gave a dose of it to Peter. Chamomile tea, a hot drink made from the herb chamomile. Dose, the amount, usually of medicine, to be taken. His mother put him to bed and made some chamomile tea, and she gave a dose of it to Peter.
Straight off to bed for you, Peter, and a
basket.
Straight off to bed for you, Peter, and a good dose of medicine.
You know the old woman who lived... His mother put him to bed. 1 tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime. Tablespoonful. A measurement. Bedtime. When it is time to go to bed at night. 1. But Flopsy, Mopsy and 1 tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime. But Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. Supper? The meal eaten in the evening. But Flopsy,
Poor Peter. I like bread and milk and blackberries. So do I.
The end. The end. The Tale of Benjamin Bunny. One morning, a little rabbit sat on a bank. He pricked his ears and listened to the trit-trot, trit-trot of a pony. Morning. The first part of the day when you wake up after the night. Bank. The ground along the edge of a river or road, often steeply sloping. Pricked his ears, raised and turned his ears towards a sound. Trit-trot. The sound of a horse's hooves when it is trotting. One morning, a little...
I believe I can hear a pony.
Very well then, we'll read you the story.
A gig was coming along the road. It was driven by Mr. McGregor, and beside him sat Mrs. McGregor in her best bonnet. Old Mr. Pricklepin has never a cushion to stick his pins in. His nose is black and his beard is grey, and he lives in an ash stump over the way. Lane. As soon as they had passed, little Ben... A gig was coming along the road. It was driven by Mr. McGregor, and beside him sat Mrs. McGregor in her best bonnet. Gig. An old-fashioned, two-wheeled, horse-drawn carriage. Along. From one end to the other. Run along. Off you go, Mr. McGregor. A gardener who does not like rabbits eating his vegetables. Mrs. McGregor. Mr. McGregor's wife, who put Peter Rabbit's father in a pie. Bonnet. A hat which ties under the chin with ribbons, which used to be worn by women when they went out. As soon as they had passed, little Benjamin Bunny slid down into the road and set off with a hop, skip and a jump. Benjamin Bunny, Peter Rabbit's cousin, slid, moved over something quickly and smoothly. Hop, to jump, especially on one foot, jump, to move up or spring suddenly off the ground. As soon as they had passed, little Benjamin Bunny slid down into the road and set off with a hop, skip and a... to call upon his relations, who lived in the wood at the back of Mr. McGregor's garden. Call upon. To visit. Relations. Members of your family, such as an aunt or an uncle. A relative. To call upon his relations, who lived in the wood at the back of Mr. McGregor's garden.
Very well then. We'll read you the story.
That wood was full of rabbit holes, and in the neatest, sandiest hole of all lived Benjamin's aunt and his cousins Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. Rabbit hole. Underground burrow where rabbits live. Sandiest. With the most sand. Cousin. Your aunt or uncle's child. Flopsy. One of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Mopsy. One of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Cottontail. One of Peter Rabbit's three sisters. Peter Rabbit. A naughty rabbit who steals Mr. McGregor's vegetables. That wood was full of rabbit.
I hope your paws are clean, my dears.
Yes, Mother. Yes, Mother. Yes, Mother.
I hope your paws are clean, my dears.
Wood. An area where a lot of trees and other plants grow together. That wood was full. Old Mrs. Rabbit was a widow. She earned her living by knitting rabbit wool mittens and muffer tees. I once bought a pair at a bazaar. Widow. A woman whose husband has died. Mittens. Gloves without separate fingers. Muffer tees. Fur or knitted cuffs used to keep your hands warm. Bazaar. A market where there are lots of small stalls selling different things. A sale of work. Old Mrs. Rabbit was a...
We shall need some more lavender soon.
Mother, we would like some tea. Mother, we would like some tea.
She also sold herbs and rosemary tea and rabbit tobacco, which is what we call lavender. Rosemary tea. A type of tea that is made from the herb called rosemary. Rabbit tobacco. Another name for the herb lavender. Lavender. A sweet-smelling bush with pale purple flowers in summer. She also sold herbs and... Little Benjamin did not very much want to see his aunt. Root. He came round the back of the fir tree and nearly tumbled upon the top of his cousin Peter. Tumbled upon. Fell on top of. He came round the back of the fir tree and nearly tumbled upon the top of his cousin Peter. Peter was sitting by himself. He looked poorly and was dressed in a red cotton pocket handkerchief.
What's wrong with you, Peter?
Red cotton pocket handkerchief. A piece of cloth kept in your pocket to blow your nose. Made of red cotton fabric. Peter...
Peter, said little Benjamin in a whisper, who has got your clothes?
Whisper. A very quiet voice.
Peter.
Peter replied, the scarecrow in Mr. McGregor's garden, and described how he'd been chased about the garden and had dropped his shoes and coat. Dropped. Allowed to fall to the ground. Describe. To say what something or someone is like. Dropped. Allowed to fall to the ground. Let go. Peter replied, Little Benjamin sat down beside his cousin and assured him that Mr. McGregor had gone out in a gig and Mrs. McGregor also. Assured, certain of something. Little Benjamin sat, and certainly for the day, because she was wearing her best bonnet, Peter said he hoped that it would rain.
Mrs. McGregor had on her best hat. I hope it rains then.
At this point, old Mrs. Rabbit's voice was heard inside the rabbit hole, calling, Cottontail, Cottontail, fetch some more chamomile. Fetch. Go for something. Collect. Chamomile. A herb often used for medicine. At this point, old Mrs. Rabbit's voice was heard in
Hurry now, Cottontail!
Peter said he thought he might feel better if he went for a walk.
Come on then, Peter!
They went away hand in hand and got upon the flat top of the wall at the bottom of the wood. From here they looked down into Mr. McGregor's garden. They went away hand in hand and got upon the flat top of the wall at the bottom of the wood. From here they looked down into Mr. McGregor's garden. Peter's coat and shoes were plainly to be seen upon the scarecrow, topped with an old tam o' shanter of Mr. McGregor's. Plainly, simply, clearly. Tam o' shanter, a Scottish hat for men. Peter's coat and shoes were plainly to be seen upon the...
Look at that, Peter!
Little Benjamin said, It spoils people's clothes to squeeze under a gate. The proper way to get in is to climb down a pear tree. Spoils, damages, ruins, proper, correct, right, pear tree. A tree pears grow on. Little Benjamin said, Peter fell down head first, but it was of no consequence, as the bed below was newly raked and quite soft. Of no consequence, not important. Raked, cleared of leaves and twigs, and smoothed with a rake. Peter fell down.
Take care, Peter!
It had been sown with lettuces. They left a great many odd little footmarks all over the bed, especially little Benjamin, who was wearing clogs. Footmarks. Footprints. Marks in the ground where someone has walked. Clogs. Heavy wooden-soled shoes, worn in the country to protect the feet from mud and wet. It had been sown with lettuces. They left a great many odd little footmarks all over the bed, especially little Benjamin, who was wearing clogs. Little Benjamin said that the first thing to be done was to get back Peter's clothes in order that they might be able to use the pocket handkerchief.
We'll need the handkerchief, Peter.
Pocket handkerchief. A piece of cloth which is kept in the pocket to blow your nose on. They took them off the scarecrow. There had been rain during the night. There was water in the shoes, and the coat was somewhat shrunk. shrunk. To have become smaller. They took them off the scarecrow. There had been rain during the night. There was water in the shoes. And the coat was somewhat shrunk. Benjamin tried on the Tam O'Shanter, but it was too big for him.
This hat's too loose for me.
Then he suggested that they should fill the pocket handkerchief with onions as a little present for his aunt. Present. Something you give to someone. A gift. Then he suggested that they should fill the pocket handkerchief with onions as a little present for his aunt. Onions. Onions. Beans. Lettuces. Wall. Beans. Wood. Wall. Peter did not seem to be enjoying himself. He kept hearing noises. Benjamin, on the contrary, was perfectly at home and ate a lettuce leaf. Noises. Sounds. Often loud or frightening. On the contrary. Quite the opposite. Lettuce leaf. Part of a leafy plant used in salads. Peter did not seem to be enjoying himself. He kept hearing noises. Benjamin, on the contrary, was perfectly at home and ate a lettuce leaf. He said that he was in the habit of coming to the garden with his father to get lettuces for their Sunday dinner. In the habit, doing often. He said that he was in the habit of coming to the...
Father likes this kind the best.
The name of little Benjamin's papa was old Mr. Benjamin Bunny. The lettuces certainly were very fine. Old Mr. Benjamin Bunny. Little Benjamin Bunny's father and Peter Rabbit's uncle. The name of little Benjamin's papa was old Mr. Benjamin Bunny. The lettuces certainly were very fine. Babbitt, Booster, Bumblebee. Fill up your honey bags, bring them to me. Humming and sighing with lazy wing. Where are you flying? What song do you sing? Who'll buy my honey pots? Buy them, who'll buy? Sweet heather honey, come weigh them and try. Honey bag, honey pot, home came she. Nobody buys from a big bumblebee. Diggory, diggory, delvet. A little old man in black velvet. He digs and he delves. You can see for yourselves. The mounds dug by Diggory Delvet. Basket. Wall. Bushes. The name of little Benjamin. Peter did not eat anything. He said he should like to go home. Presently he dropped half the onions. Dropped. Allowed to fall to the ground. Let go. Half. One of two equal parts of a whole thing. Peter. Little Benjamin said that it was not possible to get back up the pear tree with a load of vegetables.
Come along, Peter. We'll find the gate.
Load. something heavy to be carried. He led the way boldly towards the other end of the garden. They went along a little walk on planks under a sunny red brick wall. Boldly, bravely, without fear. Planks. Long, flat pieces of wood. Boards. He led the way boldly towards the other end of the garden.
This way!
The mice sat on their doorsteps cracking cherry stones. They winked at Peter Rabbit and little Benjamin Bunny. Cracking. Breaking open. For example, nuts. Cherry stone. The hard, nut-like seed inside a cherry. Winked. Closed one eye very quickly. The mice sat on their doorsteps cracking cherry stones. They winked at Peter Rabbit and little Benjamin Bunny. Presently, Peter let the pocket handkerchief go again.
Oh dear!
They got amongst flower pots and frames and tubs. Peter heard noises worse than ever. His eyes were as big as lollipops.
Do come on, Peter!
Corner.
I'll find you, you wee rascal.
Choose the number of flower pots you want to play with. The game is more difficult with more pots. 10 pots it will be. See if you can find 5 pairs. Not quite the same. These two are not the same. Those two are a perfect pair. Give it another try. Splendid! Those two are the same. Try another two. Splendid! Those two are the same. Let's try again. Well done! You found... You've matched them all splendidly.
They got amongst... He was a step or two in front of his cousin when he suddenly stopped. This is what those little rabbits saw round that corner. Round the corner. Around the edge or bend. He was a step or two in front of his cousin when he suddenly stopped. This is what those little rabbits saw round that corner.
Oh no! Look!
Little Benjamin took one look, and then, in half a minute less than no time, he hid himself and Peter and the onions underneath a large basket. Half a minute less than no time. A very short time. The cat got up and stretched herself, and came and sniffed at the basket. Perhaps she liked the smell of onions. Stretched, pulled or reached out to make longer. The cat got up and stretched herself and came and sniffed at the basket. Perhaps she liked the smell of onions. Wall. Basket. Anyway, she sat down upon the top of the basket. She sat there for 5 hours. I cannot draw you a picture of Peter and Benjamin underneath the basket because it was quite dark. And because the smell of onions was fearful, it made Peter Rabbit and little Benjamin cry. The sun got round behind the wood, and it was quite late in the afternoon, but still the cat sat upon the basket. At length, there was a pitter-patter, pitter-patter, and some bits of mortar fell from the wall above. Pitter-patter. Sound made by light, quick footsteps. For example, rabbit's paws. Mortar. A mixture of sand, cement, and water used to stick bricks together in building. At length, there was a pitter-patter, pitter-patter, basket. The cat looked up and saw old Mr. Benjamin Bunny prancing along the top of the wall of the upper terrace. Prancing. Jumping about in a playful, lively manner. Terrace. A raised, flat area like a shelf in the ground. The cat looked up and saw old Mr. Benjamin He was smoking a pipe of rabbit tobacco and had a little switch in his hand. He was looking for his son. Switch. A long, thin stick. Old Mr. Bunny had no opinion whatever of cats. He took a tremendous jump off the top of the wall onto the top of the cat and cuffed it off the basket. Tremendous. Huge and powerful. Jump. To move up or spring suddenly off the ground. Cuffed. Hit with the flat of the hand. Old Mr. Bunny had a basket. And kicked it into the greenhouse, scratching off a handful of fur. The cat was too much surprised to scratch back. Greenhouse. A building made mostly of glass, in which to grow plants and protect them from the cold. Scratch. A scraping sound. And kicked it into the greenhouse, scratching off a When old Mr. Bunny had driven the cat into the greenhouse, he locked the door.
You may stay in there.
Then he came back to the basket and took out his son Benjamin by the ears and whipped him with the little switch. Whipped. Hit with a switch. Then he came back to the basket and took out his son Benjamin by the ears and whipped him with the little switch. Then he took out his nephew, Peter. Then he took out the handkerchief of onions and marched out of the garden. Marched. Walked firmly, like a soldier. Then he took out his nephew, Peter. Then he took out the... When Mr. McGregor returned, about half an hour later, he observed several things which perplexed him. He observed several things which perplexed, confused, muddled, half, one of two equal parts of a whole thing. When it looked as though some person had been walking all over the garden in a pair of clogs, only the footmarks were too ridiculously little. Ridiculously, in a silly way, it looked... Also, he could not understand how the cat could have managed to shut herself up inside the greenhouse, locking the door upon the outside. Managed. Was able. Could. Also, when Peter got home, his mother forgave him because she was so glad to see that he had found his shoes and coat.
I found my coat and shoes, Mother, and here are some onions for you.
Now, who is this knocking at Cottontail's door?
To begin, you must choose.
When Peter got home, his mother forgave. Cottontail and Peter folded up the pocket handkerchief. And old Mrs. Rabbit strung up the onions and hung them from the kitchen ceiling with the bunches of herbs and the rabbit tobacco. Strung up. Hung up. And old Mrs. Rabbit strung up the onions and hung them from the kitchen ceiling with the bunches of herbs and the rabbit tobacco. The end.